Okay. Hello everyone, I'm Yinpu Ma from Cognitive Deep Learning Research Group of Siemens. And my research is about declarative memories. It's the structure of the human memory, cognitive memory functions that are classified into sensory memory, short-term memory, and long-term memory. And my work is focused on semantic episodic memory, belongs to declarative memories. And since semantic memory, in our work, semantic memory can be treated as a semantic knowledge graph. And for example, California is located in USA. And episodic memory is kind of memory you experience and you can recall at a certain time. So it can be described as a quadruple. For example, I visit doctor at journaling. And to model these memory functions, we use the techniques from querying large relational data set called tensor decomposition. And the idea is basically you introduce for each symbol an index neuron. And for each index neuron, you introduce a latent representation for it. And the latent representation is derived from the tensor decomposition. And episodic memory, the truth value of the triple SPOT, subject, predicate, object, and time, is actually given by the tensor product, look like that way. And this one's for semantic, the other one's for episodic. So it's semantic, so it's tensor product of three-way tensor. Anyway, if you're interested, look at my poster 23. And the most important thing is that we make a hypothesis that the semantic memory can be derived from episodic memory. Not just simply remove the time indices, it's actually by a kind of projection that it looks very similar, actually inspired by the sum product network by Pedro Domingos. And here's the result. Here's the projection, here's the semantic memory. You can see there, the projection really works. Okay, and we also have some following works and to relax the index neuron with some kind of stable activation pattern. So in this way, we can actually model some kind of associative memory or even consciousness flaw argued by Quiroga in his famous work of concept cells. Okay, and there's some few words that not in these slides that when we build this cognitive system and once we get the latent representation, we can perform predictions and even inference, and that is and that it has been used for the clinical data, for example, used to for prescription and disease prediction, and also as in our framework, we also add semantic decoding as kind of generalization of hippocampal indexing theory, and so that the system can understand the sensory input. And ask me any questions. Okay, thank you.